Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Today we are going to study symmetry. Let's discuss symmetry. Symmetry plays an important role in our environment. Look around you at the building, bridges, tunnels, windows, etc. Do you notice that symmetrical shapes are commonly used and appear almost everywhere? If you look at the example of a butterfly, the center line is the line of symmetry. When an object is symmetrical, we see that its two halves are mirror images. I repeat once again, when an object is symmetrical, we can see that its two halves are mirror images. If the figure is symmetrical, the part to the left side of the axis will fit exactly onto the part to the right side of the axis, and vice versa. Let's take an example of a triangle and let's say this is an equilateral triangle. So how many lines of symmetry can we draw? One from the top, the second line from the right hand side, and a third line from the left hand side. So there will be three lines of symmetry in an equilateral triangle. Let's discuss exercise 13A, question number 1. It says, which of the following shapes have no lines of symmetry at all? For example, case A, it's a parallelogram, and in a parallelogram there are no lines of symmetry. Case B, it's a rectangle, and in a rectangle there are two lines of symmetry, one from the top and the second one in the between. Similarly, the rest of the cases you can do it by yourself in the book with pencil. And in case of any query, please you may refer. In question number 2, it says, how many lines of symmetry are there in the following shapes? In question number 2, case A is an isosceles triangle. The right side and the left side, these two sides are equal. So we need to identify how many lines of symmetry are there in the following, in this case. So there is only one line of symmetry in this shape. Let's say if there is another triangle, an isosceles triangle, where this and this side, these two sides are equal, and this is an isosceles triangle. So in this case, how many lines of symmetry will be there? Again, in this case, there will be only one line of symmetry, like this. Let's discuss part case B of question number 2. You need to identify how many lines of symmetry will be there. So again, in this case, there will be one line of symmetry. The rest of the cases, you can do it by yourself. Okay, let's discuss question number 4. Question number 4 says, copy the following diagrams and draw the axis of symmetry for each diagram. How many lines of symmetry does each of them have? You can do this question in your book with the pencil. In case A, two circles are there. which are overlap over each other. The vertical line from the center, it can be a line of symmetry, and the second line of symmetry would be a horizontal line. So this is also the line of symmetry. Okay, in case B, it's an oval shape figure, and we need to identify how many lines of symmetry are there. So one from the center horizontally and one from the center in the vertical way. So the rest, I hope the rest of the questions you can do it by yourself, and that's it for today.